for our short discourse, the topic of our presentation is your story is not over. Shall we pray? Most High and loving God, even now, O God, I invite your holy presence among us, O God. Father, fill me, O God, and work in me and through me like never before. Father, be with all the individuals that is watching, all the individuals that is listening, O God. Let this word that you have prepared for us this morning go forth with fire and vigor, O God. And let somebody that is listening to the sound of my voice be called closer to you, I pray, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Your story is not over. I invite you to take your Bible in hand and turn to Job chapter 1, where it reads, "Then the Lord asked Satan, have you considered my servant Job? There is no one like him on earth. The man is blameless as well as upright. He fears God and keeps away from evil." And then Job chapter 2 verse 9 said, "Then his wife told him, do you remain firm in your integrity? Curse God and die. But he replied to her, you are talking like foolish woman do. Are we to accept what is good from God, but not tragic? Throughout all this, Job did not sin by what he said." Then Job's three friends heard all these tragedies that happened to him. They each traveled from their hometown to visit him. And they met together and counseled him. My friends, in the time that we live in it, my friends, in this short moment that we are living in, have you ever taken a time to think about your story? My friends, as we look at the life of Job, we recognize that Job was going through the tests of his life. Just like you and I will go through the tests of our life. And just like Job, we might have a good friend, we might have a wife or a husband, we might have a family member or a co-worker that tell us, hey there, boy, you're serving God. Look at what's coming your way. You're about to lose your job. You there, boy, you're serving God. Look at you. Your health is deteriorating. You there, boy, you're serving God. Look at you. Your marriage is on the rocks. You there, boy, you're serving God. Look at your children, them. You there, boy, you're serving God. But look at your situation. But I've stopped by to tell somebody this morning that despite the circumstances that you're in, despite what you're going through this morning, there need to be a Job within you, because you can't just accept the wonderful things that may come to your life, but you also have to accept the tragic things that may come to your life. My friends, we are going through a time when there need to be some jobs in our life. We are going through a time when we need to stand boldly and declare that despite what I'm going through, we ought and I ought to praise my God. You see, oftentimes when sickness come, when marital problem come, when our kids them start to get on in ways that we can't explain, it is so easy to crumble. It is so easy to blame someone else. It is so easy to say God don't love us. But the last time I checked, the only way a teacher can know if a student understand what is being taught is by giving them a test. Sadly, for some of us, we'll face the tests and we'll get to all 100%. While there's some of us will face the tests and see that there is room for improvement, and there's some of us that will face the tests and fail it completely. My friends, I ask you the question today: is there a Job within you? My friend, as we journey through this life, you will recognize that as you go through your moment, as you go through your situation, there are a few things that will be revealed to you. My friend, as you go through this situation, one thing that will be revealed to you is that pain reveals people. You see, a lot of us have many friends. We have husbands, we have wives, we have individuals that we conversate with on a daily basis. But the one thing that I've learned is that as you go through your pain, these individuals are revealed. Because you see, when thing is nice, I can call Evangelist Burns and we can have wonderful situation, wonderful conversation. I can call Pastor Irma and we have wonderful conversation. I can call Pastor Query and the conversation can go long, man. We talk about Jamaica and how things was and how things is. But the minute that, you know, problem come and I take up my phone and ring those conversation,
anything you're going through, you can always reach out and someone will answer that call. So I'm grateful for all the individuals that have prayed for my dad, even though they don't know him. Because that's what Joy Gospel Family is all about. When you're going through your moment, while there are friends that will not be available to assist you as you go through your storm, you can rest assured that once you come to the Joy Gospel Family, somebody will answer that call.
My friends, as you look at the story of Job, Job wife and Job friends were revealed. The same wives that Job had that was there, as we'd say in the young term, flossing when things was good. Flossing, I have all these cattle. Oh, flossing, I have all these riches. Flossing, I own all, my husband own all these land. When the storm came, she turned to her husband and said to him, "Why don't you curse God and die?" You see, some of the time you got to be careful who you listen to. And it also encourages us that we must stay connected to God. We must stay connected to God, because as you go through your storm, distractions will come. The same friends them that you used to pray with, the same friends them that you used to talk with, will be the first one to say, "Look at you, you're playing holy, but look what you're going through now." The same friends them that used to encourage you, "Ella Jerry, you're doing good. Say, Evangelist Bernie, you're doing good. Pastor Irma, you preach a powerful sermon," are the same individuals that will be trying to destroy your character. Friends of mine, you have to stay so connected to God, because in these times that we are going through, in these times that we are facing right now, there is great storm coming to us, and we have to ensure that the story that God has given us to share is not over, but the story lives on. So as we journey this morning, we want to be thankful for the life of Job, the example that he has set so far for us. Because each and every one of us will go through a storm. But as you go through that storm, my friends, I need for you to recognize that God has placed a story in your life. You see, one thing that I've always discouraged, you know, one of my friends from doing is, you know, we sit down and we reminisce on the times that we used to be of the world. And, you know, people like to tell you, oh, I used to drink, I used to smoke, I used to go to the club, I used to drink at a bar, I used to go this, and we used to do that. And for quite a while, I have been contemplating, you know, why these individuals would do something like this. And as I sat down, you know, looking through this presentation, I've recognized that, you know, some of the time we have to be careful of the things that we don't let go of. Those past memories are things of the past. It was a part of the story that led to the present story. But you don't need to dwell on that old story, because right now and then you are grateful for the lessons of the past. But you need to be even more grateful of the lessons you're learning right now. So I would like to encourage people or individuals to let go of the past story and focus on the one that you're making right now. My friends, we're going through a time that, you know, you really and truly have to recognize what God is doing in your life. Despite your situation might not be what you want it to be right now, there is a story that God is using you and you and you to fulfill. And as we look at that story, an amazing story was brought to me while I was on that flight over to Mississauga. I was there watching, you know, American Airline, and you know, in these big planes, you know, you got your TV and all of that, you know, you could watch. But for some strange reason, a clip came on about the life of an eagle. And friends of mine, this caught me off guard, because this was not what I thought happened in their life. But a clip came on about the life of an eagle and the life journey. The clip state that, you know, when an eagle get old and it be get dull and the feathers them get heavy and the claws them, you know, get break, you know, because they hunt for their food and all of that. An eagle don't just wither away and die. But to my amazement, what transpired is the eagle would go up into the mountain. And as painful as it is, the eagle will beat its beaks. It beat on a rock. Just imagine that, it beat its beak on a rock until the beak fall off and a new one grow back. All up there in the mountain, they take a beak and a beak on a rock. And when that mash up, a new one grow back. When the new beak is grown, he take the new beak and he pull out the claws them. When the new claws is grown back, he take the claw and pull out all those old feathers. And when the new feathers are grown back, the eagle return back to the hunting ground. Oh, Ella Jerry, where are you going with this? As I look at the life of an eagle, friends of mine, I'm at a point where I've recognized that each and every one of us, as we go through this Christian journey, can be like an eagle. You see, we focus so much on what we used to do that we are forgetting the new person that God had made us. As you look at the life of an eagle, when it gets old, it could just say, "So well, I can't hunt, I can't eat, and just give up and die." But no, he persevered and he go to the mountain and he go through this transformation period, as painful as it may be. And when he have gone through this process, he become a stronger person. It is the same eagle, but with new beak, new claw, and new feathers. Now let me put it to earth. You know where God have taken you from. You know the many tears that you have cried night in and out. And you know where God have placed you right now. The period to transformation may have been hard. You may have lost a lot of friends, just like Job did along the way. You may have lost a lot of loved ones, just like many of us have done along the way. But my friends, I'm here to tell you this morning that despite what you have lost, your story is not over. And this journey continues by faith with God. You might lose your good health that you had, but your story is not over. You might lose that bosom buddy friend that you normally talk to every morning, but your story is not over. Oh, you might lose that husband, that wife, or that favorite child, but your story is not over. Once you stay connected to God, my friends, there is a bigger story in place. Oh, my friends, 1 Peter chapter 5 verse says, after you have suffered for a little while, the God of all grace, who have called you by the Messiah Jesus to his eternal glory, will restore you, establish you, strengthen you, and support you. Are we talking about the life of an eagle there? The same Messiah, the same God that have called you, the same God is with you. The same God will restore you. The same God will establish you. And the same God will strengthen you. My God, friends, what I've learned, especially in the passage of a hurricane, you see, we might have lost certain things. You lose trees, you lose a computer, you lose a window, you lose a roof. But one thing that I've known is that after the passage of a hurricane, building code change, environmental code change, and now everything get built stronger and better than before. I want to go slow again. 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 10. After you have suffered for a little while, the God of all grace, who called you by the Messiah Jesus to eternal glory, will restore you, establish you, strengthen you, and support you. The hurricane will mash up a few things. The storm of life will mash up a few things. It will mash up a few relationships. It will mash up a few friendships. It will mash up a few worshipships. But the God that we serve will restore you, He will establish you. He will strengthen you. And he will support you. In the great words of Jamaica, he make you better than you was before. But the story never ends as long as you continue to trust God. My friend, as we journey through this life, each and every one of us will go through something. My friends, as we go through this life, you know, each and every one of us must lose something to gain something. But there are many of us that we don't want to lose anything at all. There are many of us that God wants to reestablish. There are many of us that God wants to restore. There are many of us that God wants to strengthen, but we don't want to let go and go through that storm so that things can get better in our life. If you want better health, let go, let God. You want better relationship, let go, let God. If you want your kids to be obedient, let go, let God. But your story is at this pause moment because you do not want to let go. Friends of mine, I don't know who I'm talking to. But somebody this morning needs to let go. Somebody this morning needs to let God. And somebody this morning needs to recognize that this is the time. And right now, it might be the after moment of your life where God is saying to you, my son, my daughter, I need for you to let go and let the story that I've put you on this earth for go on. But for some reason, some of us don't want to suffer. For some reason, some of us don't want to let go. Because we believe that what we have now is the best and don't recognize that there is something greater than what we are going through. If you look at Psalms chapter 30 verse 5, he says, for his anger remains but a moment. In his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Oh, Joy Gospel Radio comes in the morning, so it doesn't matter what you have went through last night. Today, the joy of Jesus is being given to you and I. My friend, what is your story? What is the story that God is saying to you this morning, I need for you to finish? What is the story that God is saying to you this morning? Hello, Jerry. Evangelist Victory. Evangelist Esther. I need for you to complete this story. Friends of mine, I know, I don't know your story, but I know mine. And that is such a wonderful story. Just think about it. For his anger remained but for a moment. In his favor is life. Weeping may endure for a night, my friends, but joy comes in the morning. In short, brief, I look at it as you will cry. Oh, it will be painful. But all of that is just for a little while. Oh, it will hurt because you lose some good friends along the way. But guess what? You'll gain some even better friends. My friend, what a friend we have in Jesus. What a friend we have in Jesus. But as you go through these moments, and as you pause for a moment to contemplate what it is that I need to let go, what it is God is saying to me that I need to do so that his story for my life can be fulfilled. I'd like for you to just think of 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7 where it says, for God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. My friends, oftentimes, when you think about losing someone or something or some situation, you become fearful. because you can't see any way out. I mean, just think about it. Some of us are more fearful of losing the friend that we talk to every morning than fearful of losing Jesus in our life. Some of us are fearful of losing that relationship with that husband or that wife or that child more than fearful of losing God in our life. Some of us are fearful of losing that friendship with that minister of government, that CEO of that company, that general manager, that department head, than we are fearful of losing our soul salvation. So I repeat to you again, 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7, where it says, "For God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind." There is no in this story. Wherever you are right now in your life, your story is not over. You might be up on the hospital bed. Your story is not over. You might be driving in your car, listening to the sound of my voice. Your story is not over. Or you might be home, worrying about those bills. Worrying about that argument that you just had this morning with your husband or your wife. Worrying about that last conversation that you had with that individual that you feel may not have went so well. God have not given you a story of fear, but one of power and of love and of a sound mind. This is his offer to you today. My friends, it doesn't matter where you stand. It doesn't matter what you have been through or what you're going through right now. God is saying to you, your story is not over. If you're one of those persons that is saying, "Father, here I am, O Lord. I've recognized that there is a great story. And even now, Holy Father, I'm saying to you, let this not be the end of my story, but let this be a new chapter in my life." If you're one of those persons that's saying, "Elder, just pray for me," I invite you to raise your hand physically, visually, or even over the medium as I pray. Most High and Loving Father, your son right now is saying to you, "Oh God, thank you for the work that you have started." Father, as your sons and daughters' heads are bowed and their hands are raised and their hearts are lift heavenwards this morning, oh God, we are saying, God, thank you for the story. Father, for some of us, oh God, the story has been a painful one. For some of us, oh God, the story has been a fearful one. But we are so thankful for the world this morning that help us to recognize that you do not promise fear, but of love, of power. And this morning, oh God, we're saying, oh God, we're claiming those promises. Father, visit them wherever they are, God, in their homes, oh God, in their cars, oh God, on their job, oh God, even in a jail cell, oh God, and give them this spirit. Help them to recognize, oh God, that the story right now might not be where they want it to be, but this story will be told in such a way that somebody will say, I know there is a God. Father, you know those individuals that you're speaking to this morning. Even now as they cry to you, oh God, we ask you to touch them from the crown of their head to the sole of their feet. We ask you, oh God, to move through them like never before, oh Father. Father, we ask, oh God, that your Holy Spirit will rain down from on high, oh God, and touch us in such a way, oh God, that your story that you have placed us on this earth complete will be complete. For the life of Job, we are thankful for the many tests that we have faced thus far, because by faith we have overcome and have won the victory with your help. And God, we pray that as we continue to live out this world, that we'll continue in love, recognizing your power and your grace. And God, we pray your continued blessing upon this Joy Gospel Radio family. Father, continue to bless this ministry. Continue to broaden the territory. And continue to minister